a case of murder has been filed against BJP MLA Kuldeep Sengar, who is already facing charges of rape against a teenage girl. The murder case comes a day after the rape survivor's car was hit by a speeding truck in Raibareli. Her two aunts, one of whom was a witness in her case, are now dead. The survivor's father died in police custody last year. The survivor herself is in critical condition in hospital and on a ventilator. Her case made national headlines last year after she tried to set herself on fire in front of the chief minister's office. The accused MLA is currently in jail. The FIR filed by her uncle says that the MLA was threatening the family through his men and that the police who were in the girl's security detail had informed the MLA and his associates about her travel plans. My colleague Alok Pandey brings you this report.
After this accident, a murder case against BJP MLA Kuldeep Sengar. The teenage girl who has accused Sengar of rape and her family were in a serious accident when their car collided head-on with a truck while travelling to UP's Raibareli. The FIR filed by the girl's uncle says Sengar and his men were constantly pressuring the family to withdraw the case. The FIR alleges that the cops on the girl's security detail informed Sengar and his associates about the girl's travel plan. Sengar and his associates are responsible for the incident, the FIR says. The teenage girl, meanwhile, is fighting for her life in a Lucknow hospital. Uttar Pradesh's top cop said just this morning it appears to be a case of accident. So, was it a murder attempt or an accident? On Sunday, the car the girl was travelling in with her family collided with a truck here. Two of the girl's aunts are dead. One was a witness in the rape case. This morning, Uttar Pradesh's police chief claimed she was out of danger.
Balatkar ki peedita jo hai, wo swam out of danger hai.
But later in the afternoon, doctors treating the girl in a government hospital in Lucknow said the opposite. They said the patient is very critical and on ventilator. The patient's blood pressure has gone down and is being supported with drugs. In a written complaint to the police, the family of the girl has asked for a CBI investigation into the case. Asked about the specific nature of threats from Sengar, the girl's mother told the media, "They have been threatening us for days. They would say only the MLA is in jail. He may be inside, but his men aren't." The mother says that the MLA used phones inside the jail with ease.
The 9 security personnel were with them. So if they had any complaint, then we'll definitely look into it.
It is here at 1:30 p.m. The family was travelling from Unnao to Raibareli. Coming from the opposite direction was a truck which police say was travelling from Raibareli to the Fatehpur district.
The over-speeding truck came from this direction and collided with the car at this spot.
Eyewitnesses on the spot claim the truck was speeding. The police have arrested the driver and the owner of the truck. The police say they are investigating if the truck owner or driver has any links to MLA Sengar or his people. The biggest question, why were number plates of the truck blackened and who did it?
Finance jin logon se karayi thi un logon ko usne paise nahi diye the. Is wajah se usne gaadi ka number hide kiya hua tha.
Another equally vexing question, why was the 9-member security detail assigned to the rape survivor for the last year, including a 24/7 armed gunner, not travelling with the family?
We are going, 5 people are, you are completely calm and we will come back.
But why was a separate police vehicle not assigned?
Jo static guard ki ya gunner ki suraksha hoti hai usme vahan ki suvidha nahi hoti.
Kuldeep Sengar is a 4-time MLA from Bangar Mau in the Unnao district. He's been in jail for over a year over the alleged gang rape of the teenage girl that happened in 2017. Now, of course, Mr. Sengar also faces murder charges. The BJP, though, has not expelled him. It has not suspended him. In Lucknow with Kamal Khan, Vineet Verma and Rajesh Gupta, this is Alok Pandey, NDTV.
Well, the BJP has not only not sacked Mr. Singer ever since these rape charges first came to light, but you also had the sight of BJP MP Sakshi Maharaj actually going to jail to visit this MLA only last month, soon after the election results had come out. He actually told reporters at that time that he had gone there to thank Mr. Singer and had even gone and campaigned in Unnao and gone to his house. Today, when he was asked and confronted by reporters about this murder case against the MLA, Sakshi Maharaj could only say that the matter was already being investigated.
हमारे यहाँ के बहुत ही यशस्वी लोकप्रिय विधायक कुलदीप सेंगर जी यहाँ काफी समय से हैं. चुनाव के बाद उनका धन्यवाद करना उचित समझा तो मैं आया.
उन्नाव में जो एक्सीडेंट घटना हुई है वो दुखद है, उसका हमें कष्ट है, परंतु सारे प्रकरण की हिंदुस्तान में सबसे बड़ी जांच संस्था सीबीआई जांच कर रही है, उसके बारे में कोई टिप्पणी करना उपयुक्त नहीं है.
सर, परिवार ये आरोप लगा रहा है कि पहले से उन पर
मुझे नहीं जानकारी कोई क्या कह रहा है, लेकिन सीबीआई जांच कर रही है इसलिए कोई टिप्पणी करना आवश्यक नहीं.
So is it a breakdown of law and order in Yogi's Raj? Joining us tonight, the former DGP of Uttar Pradesh, Mr. Vikram Singh. Also with us, Senior Advocate of the Supreme Court, Vrinda Grover. We've got Tehsin Poonawala here back in the studio with us, Shivam Vij, the contributing editor of The Print, and Dr. Geeta Bhatt, who's a political analyst and RSS supporter, is with us, and Vivek Reddy of the BJP is joining us from Bangalore tonight. Mr. Singh, to you first. You know, you just look at the glaring lapses that have taken place just, you know, in this preliminary investigation of this case. So many unanswered questions. This rape survivor had 9 security personnel that were assigned to her. None of them were with her in the car. The police told reporters first today that she was stable. Now it turns out she's, you know, on a ventilator and we don't know if she'd even make it. Your first thoughts, sir, on the way this case has been handled?
There are too many loose ends that are just and inexplicable. Firstly, as you very rightly said, the relationship between the protectee and the security cover is like that of a patient and a doctor. It is not for the patient to tell what kind of treatment she would like to have. It is the job of the doctor to ensure to dispense the medicine what is the most appropriate. And to that extent, the police and the security cover failed her in the sense that they should have reported this matter to their headquarters, got reinforcements or a car or whatever, but should have ensured that the security cover was always there with the survivor. Two, the fact remains that the accident, you may recall that the truck that was responsible for the accident had the number plates blackened. And in the very fact that it moved in a very important national highway, what happened to the dial 100, what happened to the patrol cars and the nakas, that the truck moved without any checks, without any monitoring. I would again say that the telephone calls made by the driver, the cleaner and the owner needs to be scrutinized and they should be subjected to the lie detector, polygraph and the narco analysis in the next 24 hours. Obviously, it is very disconcerting to hear that the survivor is in a critical condition on a ventilator. I do hope if she regains consciousness, her statement is recorded under 164 of the CRPC before it's too late.
Well, I want to ask Mr. Vivek Reddy that, Mr. Reddy, as a member of the BJP today, would you say honestly that Mr. Singer needs to go, that there should be action taken now by the party at least? It hasn't taken any action yet, but that this is now really too much?
Well, I think this investigation forms an independent part of whatever has happened today, and it has to be examined with a lot of scrutiny, gravity and seriousness. And if even if a little information has come regarding the involvement of Mr. Singer in this, at least the initial investigations point out the same, I think the BJP will be taking action and it has to take action against him. And this is only to show that there is zero tolerance towards such incidents. And definitely, Nidhi, action will be taken if there is even fundamental or basic proof. Regarding his
Mr. Reddy, what is this zero tolerance? I mean, this man has been arrested by the CBI for rape and he's in jail already for a year on the rape charge by the CBI. So what is this zero tolerance that the BJP talks about? There is no zero tolerance. There is only tolerance.
Well, a BJP MLA under the BJP government is in the jail for 1 year. So there is no prejudice regarding the
why is he still in the party?
Number one.
Should he not have been sacked?
Second, hold on. Second is that he is facing trial as any citizen. Imagine, Nidhi, he has not been allowed to come out. And that is very clear. The BJP's tolerance, zero tolerance, is exhibited there. And the investigation is taken over by CBI in order to ensure fairness and honesty.
If it Therefore, is fairness and honesty, you don't think that as a sitting MLA, he commands a considerable degree of influence with people who are around him? You don't think that that's the case? If this was a fair and honest investigation, as you said, you don't think he should have been kicked out from the party? He should have been suspended, at least until the trial was over?
Well, the party will take a decision on that. The party will take a decision, but so far as his investigation, the crime and the neutrality of pursuing the offender is concerned, I think the state government and the CBI has ensured that the offender is in the jail and he faces trial and without any compromise regarding the neutrality of trial. And that is more important.
Yes, but
the
now
machinery of the state is launched
fully
against
him. But now his victim could lose her life, and that's, you know, just by the way. Vrinda Grover, it's an astonishing, sort of miscarriage of justice that we're seeing unraveling before our eyes. Vrinda, I mean, what do you say to the BJP and to the UP government, which seems to pat itself on the back for law and order? Ironically, just yesterday, the Home Minister was saying what a great job Mr. Adityanath is doing in UP.
You know, Nidhi, this is a textbook case of how impunity is allowed to take place. It doesn't happen on its own. Let's just remember a few things. Even the initial FIR was lodged when the girl and her mother attempted to immolate themselves. The machinery of the state did not act on its own. The incident, this girl had disappeared, she had been kidnapped. Then she was gang raped repeatedly. The parents, of course, being poor, nobody heard them. When they tried to immolate themselves in front of the CM's house, the FIR was lodged. The incident dates back to June 2017. We are in July 2019. Finally, the charge sheet was filed in July 2018. The BJP MLA, who I'm completely flummoxed by the use of the phrase zero tolerance, has a charge sheet against him under POCSO and the IPC for rape of a minor girl. He has a charge sheet against himself, his brother and other police officers for murder in judicial custody of the father of this minor girl. The law says that within 1 year, the trial under POCSO will be completed. The 1 year is over in 2019.
It hasn't even started.
What is the state prosecution doing? Exactly. So when they are saying that there is neutrality, what you require is the state prosecutor to ensure that the case moves. He's in jail still because the court has not granted him bail. At least let's retain a pretense that the state is not deciding, sorry, the government is not deciding who's in or out of jail. The court gets to decide that. What we are seeing here is very clearly that in the first instance, she was raped because this man abused his position and authority. And that is the only narrative that continues to flow. There is no reason for us to think that this is going to change. The political will has manifested itself by not even expelling him or suspending him for over 2 years. There is no reason for us to believe otherwise. The message is loud and clear. And you said so, I was not aware. You said that Sakshi Maharaj, the other MLA MP, has visited him. Why has the girl's evidence not been recorded till now?
Absolutely.
The most secure form of victim witness protection is to record her evidence.
Absolutely.
After that, it does not help to harm or injure her.
So
we know that only last week or recently, the Supreme Court raised a concern about the alarming rise in child rape cases and no adjudication. This is the emblematic case.
Which is why
case.
It's all the more
the
appalling.
The message is out
this
there.
This is
you
Geeta
are going
Bhatt.
To seek justice.
Geeta Bhatt, this is a man accused of raping a minor. You know, I mean, it's the most horrendous kind of crime that you can be accused of, for which he's sitting in jail. And you really believe that it was proper for Sakshi Maharaj, as a member of parliament, to go and thank him, to visit him in jail, that he should not have been expelled by now? Do you really think that that has been a big mistake that the BJP has made in not kicking him out of the party?
See, no one can, you know, no one would stand with a man who has been, you know, accused of such a heinous crime. There is an echo, if you can please correct it. You know, someone who has done such a heinous crime. And that is the reason that in spite of the government, the same party government being there in Uttar Pradesh, the accused MLA is behind bars for the last 1 year. There are 3 CBI cases which have been registered, which is related to this case. Besides this, Allahabad High Court, on the orders of Allahabad High Court, there is another court case which CBI has registered, where that girl had, you know, accused some other boys of doing the same kind of misbehavior with her. Now, you see, you know, all such cases, Nidhi, where, you know, women have been subjected to, you know, such kind of a heinous crime, they need to be raised, they need to be protested, and justice must be brought to these girls. Please also remember that, you know, there yesterday only in Rajasthan, in Jaipur also, a woman who has been going again.
There is no whataboutery. Madam, I'm stopping you right there. I'm not letting you do whataboutery. I want to ask you a simple question, Geeta Bhatt, because whataboutery will be cut off. We are talking about UP and we're not talking about Rajasthan. Please tell me why Mr. Sengar is still an MLA of the BJP. Why has he not been sacked? Why has he not been kicked out of the party? No whataboutery. No whataboutery. If you will do whataboutery, I will move on.
No.
Please, do you believe, Geeta Bhatt, that he should not ask you a question, ma'am?
Why do we not want to talk about?
Because we are talking about Uttar Pradesh. I am asking you about this case. Why has this BJP MLA not been sacked? Why has he not been sacked for 2 years, madam? There is no selective. Ma'am, please answer the question on this. Because I'm sorry, this is a tried and tested tactic to divert issues, to not focus on issues. Why has Mr. Sengar not been sacked?
There is a result in this case, but the same needs to be done even for the Rajasthan government. The question.
Can I ask you a simple question, Geeta Bhatt? Geeta Bhatt,
who is not
should Mr. Sengar have been sacked from the BJP, and should he be sacked now? Yes or no?
Well, you see, this call has to be taken. You see,
in your opinion, I have an opinion. I think he should be sacked. What is your opinion?
Accused is convicted of the charges. Yes, the government needs to. The government needs, and any political party needs to take an action, and should not have such kind of people in their party. That would be for their own good. No doubt about it.
Okay,
but
great.
The point is, when there are other state governments also, we need to raise questions to all such governments.
No, because it's classic. We're talking about UP, madam. We're talking about an MLA accused of rape and murder. This is a sitting MLA accused of rape and murder in Uttar Pradesh. We are not talking about Rajasthan. We're not talking about Chhattisgarh. We're not talking about UK, America, Brexit, blah, blah, blah. Okay, we're talking about this case. Tehsin Poonawala.
Yes, Nidhi, it is the same case. It is the same Uttar
Geeta
Pradesh.
Ji, my name is Tehsin, unless you've done a ghar vapsi or ghar.
Well, at least Geeta Bhatt is saying Mr. Sengar should be sacked. That's a relief.
His ministerial position.
Tehsin.
You know, Nidhi, I'm sitting here with you for now in the last 1 month, the upteenth number of time, and Mr. Vivek Reddy has come and said, oh, but the Prime Minister will take actions. We are tired of these feelings of the Prime Minister. When will we see concrete action? Neither on Sadhvi Pragya, neither on Vijay Vargiya's son, neither out here. The Prime Minister never takes action. His feelings somewhere only translates in his heart, through sources, comes to certain news channels, and then it ends there. Nothing happens. But what are the facts of this case? A minor girl who, again, the Prime Minister said people are hung to death in 3 days for raping minors. This was something the Prime Minister said. He was fact-checked on that. The minor girl accuses a sitting MLA of rape. Our minister, an MP, goes to thank her. The case is only taking cognizance when everybody steps in, when the courts step in. And even yet, if we are saying that everything that the BJP government has done is correct, then let's ask some questions. The Home Minister of UP is Yogi Adityanath. What action is taken on the police for not giving her cover, for whatever reason that she refused cover? What action is taken? Zero. What action is taken under DGPUP for misleading the media by saying primary fasciitis happens to be a case of accident? If this was a case of accident, why CBI today registered a case a few hours later of case of murder? If there is a case of murder that has been registered, why is this MLA not thrown out of the party? There are just too many contradictory ends. You cannot go away by saying the Prime Minister has a great heart and of course he will take action. The proof of the Dhokla is in the eating. You take action. Stop coming to news channels and giving us whataboutery of what happened everywhere else in the world.
Shivam Vij, do you think that Mr. Adityanath will act now or will actually brazen it out? Because it is possible that will also happen.
I don't think he'll act. I think his government is given complete impunity to Mr. Sengar and his associates in this case. I mean, you have to understand the role of the police here. It's not Kuldeep Singh Sengar actually who's the main problem here. The main culprit is the UP police. The FIR in fact says that the security given to the rape victim was the one informing the truck driver of her movements, right?
Yeah,
so the UP police is completely complicit in what has happened. And the UP police is run by Yogi Adityanath directly, in fact, the Home Ministry is under him. I think we have to understand here the difference between Gundaraj and Jangal Raj. On any given day, UP, Bihar have Gundaraj. Lots of crime, rape and murder, criminals flourish. Jangal Raj is when there's impunity, when the criminals know that I can do this and get away with it and nothing will happen to me. For instance, Lalu Yadav's years in the 90s in Bihar were called Jangal Raj. I think UP under Yogi Adityanath has crossed from Gundaraj into Jangal Raj.
Kumar.
He is unequivocally the worst Kumar. Chief Minister in India today. Raghubar Das of Jharkhand comes a close second, but Yogi Adityanath is the new Lalu Yadav Jangal Raj era. And the BJP will pay a heavy price if they don't remove him. Before sacking Kuldeep Singh Sengar, they need to sack Yogi Adityanath because, you know, an army captain, retired army captain in Amethi is lynched to death. In Sonbhad, the criminals go and massacre tribals for land grab. Clearly, criminals in UP have no fear of the law because the law is on their side. Policemen are just busy, you know, massaging Kawariyas because law and order is not something they're supposed to do. So I think we need to hit here not at Kuldeep Singh Sengar, but at his boss who's protecting him, who's not sacking him from the party, who is, you know, for instance, I give an example of the impunity here. The rape victim's uncle was accused of beating up the MLA or one of his associates, and he has already been sentenced to 10 years in prison. His trial is over, he's convicted, he's spending 10 years
here,
in bribery.
The rape of a minor has not started.
The trial of the rape itself against Mr. Sengar has not even started. So that tells you.
The charge sheet is not filed. This is so, directly under Yogi. He's the Home Minister.
So Yogi Adityanath does not want Kuldeep Singh Sengar convicted. Right, he will be, you know, what Geeta Bhatt was saying, that he's innocent until proven guilty. When he's convicted, he'll be sacked. But he'll never be convicted because the UP government will make sure he's not convicted.
Geeta Bhatt, do you want to sort of respond to that? And just, you know, what is going on in Uttar Pradesh at the moment, ma'am? I mean, you know, the sight of the police washing the feet of Kanwariyas, showering flowers on them. You know, you have Sonbhadra on one hand. You have this Amethi lynching on the other that has also happened overnight. And of course, this case. What is the UP police doing?
Well, Nidhi, if you if you talk about the state of the police forces, I think for a very long time, a lot of reforms are required as far as the police forces. If we want that they should be, you know, they should be there doing their duty, a large number of police reforms are required. Now, the point is that while you are just talking about, you know, each one of us is entitled for their opinion, but the point is that the Congress, can I please complete? In Rajasthan, no one is talking, you know, very conveniently people have avoided talking about a woman who has immolated herself in Jaipur yesterday. Nobody wants to talk about her state and
no, because,
so many others.
Because we're talking about UP and we're talking about a sitting MLA in UP. We're talking about Uttar Pradesh and a sitting MLA in Uttar Pradesh. We'll not let this whataboutery come in.
The police forces, Nidhi, across the point, that is what I am saying. Let there be no selectivity, you know, this is what is being calling politicizing,
you are doing,
you know,
selectivity by not admitting that the Yogi government has not done justice to rape victims here. You are being selective.
This is what is happening across the states.
The problem is your selectivity, Geeta Bhatt.
What is happening in Rajasthan? No one is raising a finger and talking.
What more justice? He's been in jail for 1 year.
What more justice? Vivek Reddy? Vivek Reddy? She's in hospital battling for her life, Vivek Reddy. What do you mean by what more justice?
He has to be prosecuted.
Who will prosecute him?
Has he been free?
Will Rajasthan government
is the best to look at? The law is
done. You're not raising
the
finger.
The law is done.
Why
he has been inside for 1 year. He's been in jail.
Mr. Reddy, Mr.
You are shying away.
One second. Mr. Reddy, okay guys, 1 second.
How
is he treated as an ordinary man? He's still an MLA, Mr. Reddy. He's still a member of the BJP. He is accused of raping a child.
Come on,
Mr. Reddy.
He's a representative of the people.
He's a representative of the people. How are you saying that there is justice on a day when this girl is fighting for her life on a ventilator? Mr. Reddy.
Hasn't he been in jail from the date of the crime?
So, that's because the courts are not giving him bail.
Hasn't he been investigated
by the
CBI?
What favour has the state government done by keeping him in jail?
The state government not filing charges.
CBI has locked him up in jail.
Mr. Reddy, under the law, this trial should have finished by now. Under the law, this trial should have finished by now. Alright, it hasn't even started. Whose fault is that? Please tell me.
Look here, POSCO trials don't end anywhere in India. It's an outer guideline. Please don't look at what that framework and say that, you know, it
Mr.
has not
Mr. Reddy,
ended.
You're
throughout
pregnant
India,
or you're not pregnant. There is a law or there is no law. There is nothing called outer guideline
talking?
In law.
What are
there
you
is
talking?
Nothing. This
I
is
think,
nonsense.
I think
at least come on TV. There is no
need,
thing called outer guideline in law.
Let me get Rinda.
I've never heard of outer guideline in law.
Neither have I. I'm learning every day. Indian TV is teaching us everything every day.
I don't think you know how POSCO courts
No, I don't know what's an outer guideline in law.
Have you gone there? I'm a lawyer.
Nobody knows.
Have you gone to POSCO courts?
Thankfully, no. Thankfully, no. And thankfully, I don't want to be a BJP MLA who goes there.
Yes.
Yes, Mr. Reddy. Thankfully, no.
At least go there as a witness.
As a witness,
one second, Vrinda.
In the studio.
Vrinda Grover.
Stop sitting
wants
in the studio and commenting. Go there and find out the realities.
Vrinda.
That's the problem with you.
Vrinda Grover.
Are you high on something?
I have been.
Vrinda Grover.
I have been to POSCO court. I appear in POSCO court on behalf of child victims, assisting the prosecution. Whether a case is going to move as it should, to think that in 1 year the main witness has not been examined and then to say CBI has done a laudable work is, I think, completely false. Please understand
that depends
it is
on the court,
CBI,
it
which is
on the
also
judge,
the prosecuting
it does not
agency.
Depend on the CBI prosecutor.
Why?
Let us know that there are various circumstances, Brinda Gova, and
really?
You being an expert,
they can't record
faults.
Her statement in 1 year, is it?
It could be due to various reasons. Does Brinda Govan know why as to the reasons? Does she know exactly as to why
do
the
you
trial
know why?
Has not commenced in 1 year? She
do
doesn't
you know
have
why?
Details.
Mr. Reddy,
she
please.
Doesn't have details.
Please don't. Let her finish her point.
The normal reasons are the court is overloaded. Courts are overloaded.
Okay, that
and
is the
is
reason
so
why.
90% of the cases.
That is why the victim's statement can't be recorded.
So why are you selecting this?
Vrinda Grover.
Come on. Please don't. Let us not bring down this discussion to such silly reasons.
Mr. Reddy, do you want to tell that? Do you want to tell that to this girl who's fighting for her life in hospital today? Can we at least show some decorum, some empathy? Can there be some empathy for this girl who's a child?
It has to be.
She's only 17 years old.
We are showing, but...
What? Where are you showing?
What sort of blame mindset that is being brought
what
up
What is
here?
Blame mindset? I'm asking you a simple question.
The blame mindset.
Why is
you
this man still a member of the BJP?
I mean, in
how is he still an MLA?
Of POSCO cases, 1 year guideline is not adhered to. So, whom are you blaming here?
Okay, can Vrinda Grover answer that
Why
question?
Why the blame mindset?
Vrinda Grover, Mr. Reddy says that it's been a very busy time for the prosecution and the courts. So, it's wrong for you to question why this case hasn't even started in 1 year.
Well, actually, the Supreme Court is questioning it. The Chief Justice of India took suo motu action on precisely this point. Perhaps Mr. Reddy would like to file an affidavit there, giving the litany of reasons that he has just laid down. The government is repeatedly passing amendments to the POXO law, ensuring higher and higher penalty. The truth of the matter is that the prosecutions are not taking place. Would CBI not have considered that a case of this nature, where a sitting MLA, obviously very powerful, where even MPs go and visit him in prison, this case would qualify for transfer like the Kathua case did? I do not recall the CBI moving a transfer application. It is not possible that in a case of this nature, the evidence of the girl victim is not recorded in a year. It is completely uncharacteristic and unusual of any trial that takes place in the POXO court. What one can see clearly is that there are ways in which the prosecution, the security, the police, the investigation is delaying, dragging. We are hearing that the family says that they are continuously under intimidation, pressure and threat.
Exactly.
The way said that the only person who any such delay will benefit.
Which is the point I made. How do you have a fair and transparent case in UP with a sitting MLA who is an accused?
The Kathua case was on a prejudiced court or prejudiced mindset.
Oh my God.
Prejudiced court.
I'm really sorry.
Prejudiced mindset.
I'm sorry. That Mr. Reddy, that is contempt of court.
And I have contempt of court.
That is not the case here.
Well,
sorry.
Mr. Reddy, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
To see the extent to which Mr. Reddy will go to defend a rapist.
It is not.
Defending a rapist, Mr. Reddy. Stop defending a rapist. Stop defending a rapist, Mr. Reddy.
A dying declaration by the Supreme Court is considered as evidence.
Why are you defending a rapist?
Maybe you should get out of WhatsApp University. Stop defending rapists. And get down to doing some serious work.
I want to ask Mr. Vikram Singh the final question.
You are nobody is defending rapists.
You are.
You clearly are defending a rapist. You clearly have no empathy. But what's worst is you seem to have no intelligence as well.
Your blame mindset. You are misleaders and blamers. That is what I'm attacking.
Well, Mr. Vikram Singh, I am not getting this is, I mean, this is the new death to which
I'm glad to be an expert in anything except for being an expert like how Yogi Adityanath in ruining a state.
Mr. Vikram Singh, sir, the point that was raised about the complicity of the UP police.
That is none of your
concern. So you have worked with this force.
It is, it's my country. Sorry.
You have worked with this force, sir. And is there an urgent need to just look at how the police force is conducting itself? In UP at the moment?
Nidhi, I would say that the UP police is the largest police force in the world. And like any police force, there is the good, the bad and the ugly. There are fault lines. And like any police force, these fault lines need to be addressed. But I would say that there were the depredations which we have not discussed. The likes of Atiq Ahmed and Mukhtar Ansari, who had deserters getting light machine guns. And then you had the murders of sitting MLA Krishna Dandrai. All that has happened in UP also. There are good things also and excellent things that have happened now. But yes, there are fault lines. Not getting the trial and not even beginning the trial, in this case of the survivor, is a horrible miscarriage of justice, and that should have happened. Again, even before the FIR is lodged, I come to a conclusion and go on television and say that this is an accident. This is also not something very professional. And I would also say that, yes, you need to put your act together and enhance your credibility. But yes, UP police is indeed learning its lessons. And with the mature guidance of its leadership, I'm sure these fault lines will be rectified.
I hope so, sir. We're going to keep a close eye on this case. Thank you to all of you for joining us. We hope and pray that this girl is able to survive. She's on a ventilator right now. By the way, Mr. Reddy, just to tell you again, she's on a ventilator. We don't know if she's going to make it. And I hope that, you know, when you sleep tonight, you can think of her for just a moment instead of thinking of Mr. Adityanath or the rest of us. This is not about us. This is about her. Thanks for joining us.